million miles away, on the emerald planet in the Moffit Galaxy, friendly creatures are aware that the planet Earth is in danger. They have received an urgent message that the salamander men of the planet Kulimon, deep in the Moffit Galaxy, are planning to attack and destroy Earth. Here the Emerald Men confer on what must be done. They are aware that the atomic destruction of Earth could contaminate their own atmosphere with radioactivity. And so they reason. In order to save themselves, they must save Earth from the impending Kulimonian invasion. Scientists of the Emerald Planet have invented one of the most ingenious mechanisms the universe has ever seen. Called a globe meter, it is carried on the wrist. It enables its wearer to do three things: to fly through space, to detect radioactivity, and to speak and understand every language on the planet Earth. Finally, this great forum of the Emerald Hierarchy reaches a decision. In order to save Earth from the Kulimonian attack, they must once more present the globe meter to one of their fellow creatures and send him to Earth. He is the creature made of the strongest steel, the creature who can disguise himself as an Earthling. He is the creature known as Starman. A cargo plane, flown by a terror-stricken crew, heads for the nearest airport.
Your attention, please. Pan American Airlines flight number 500 will land in 5 minutes from Honolulu.
What was it?
Flying objects. Perhaps they are from outer space.
We nearly didn't get away. They looked like nothing we'd seen on Earth, and they didn't respond to our radio signals either.
That's right. They seem to think that they're flying discs. They estimate that their last course is this direction. Put all planes in the immediate area on the emergency.
An emergency! An emergency! An emergency!
All planes search the area and report to tower. Make a report on all objects sighted. An emergency. An emergency. You're cleared. You're cleared. You're cleared. You're cleared.
A search of the sky fails to turn up the mysterious flying objects. But soon after the emergency alert, people begin falling ill of an unknown disease. Deadly disease spreads quickly throughout the city, despite all sanitary precautions. Scientists work on the problem night and day.
That's what we have discovered. Their symptoms are similar to cerebritis, but we haven't been able to isolate the virus.
I guess you've heard the many rumors. They say the disease was brought here in space. Discs.
One other rumor. They're speaking of evacuating the city. There'll be panic unless we can learn something. I'm certain that unless we can, it'll be the end.
I agree. We'll all die. But I feel we maybe can find the answer. We'll keep on, and by our experimentation, we'll find it. I hope. I'm not going to admit defeat.
Ah, I must get to the laboratory. Excuse me. Will you get me the cultures?
Yes.
Professor Asayama decides to study through the night. Material that I'll expel. Starman reaches the outer rim of our solar system, flying at the speed of light past Pluto and Neptune, as Professor Asayama falls under the power of the Kulimonian. Kulimonian hears a dreaded sound from outer space. The sound of Starman approaching Earth.
Oh. Tateno, I'm worried. Do you know where Father is?
He likes to walk. He must be in the garden. Let me go and take a look.
I'll go with you. All right?
What is it, Yoshiko? You seem to be rather upset tonight.
Yoshiko! We looked. We can't find Father. And we don't know where he went.
Searched the whole house and even the garden, right?
Looked in the lab? I'm sure he must be outside. I'll go and take a look. Be right back. Professor, what happened? Are you all right? Take this.
At this moment, Starman reaches Earth.
That's blood I see on your hands. What have you done tonight? Answer me.
man must take great care to avoid the Kulimonian's deadly claws, which can destroy even solid steel. Realizes the salamander men of Kulimon already are infiltrating Earth. And he realizes, too, that he faces an almost impossible challenge to save the planet.
Father, I'm glad you're going to get better.
I'd like to talk Centotenoian.
All right.
Is there something I can get you, Uncle? Anything to read?
Oh, thank you, Noriko. Nothing. I'd like your children to go out and play, if you don't mind. I have to talk to Toteno on business.
We don't mind. Just be careful not to talk too much. Let's go.
Uh-huh.
I have to talk to him privately, Yoshiko. Will you leave us alone?
Yes.
It is?
Where? Did you find it here?
It was right on the floor.
But...
You're certain it happened that way? Oh, exactly. It was a monster that attacked me. It was not of this earth.
This was a serious accident. You're not well yet. You'll feel differently later.
I'm not ill.
Very well, then. In that case, I will tell the authorities. They must hear it.
You know, I suspect there are certain things Father won't tell us about it. Rio, don't you agree?
You mean about this mysterious thing? Whatever caused his accident left it?
Yes.
Yoshiko, why don't we try to investigate?
Yes, let's. I think Tateno could help us. Let's ask him to right now.
No, don't tell him a thing. He'll only go to Father with the story.
That's right. Noriko, do you think that your brother would do it?
Oh, I think he might.
Let's ask. He's the right one. Anyway, he's a biology specialist. Let's go to him right now.
Yes, today.
Jack and Dad.
These tests reveal that this object is some kind of scale. It's from an amphibious creature.
We guessed that. Isn't there anything else that you can tell us? Haven't you any other information as to what kind of creature?
Not yet. We arrived at certain theories which we don't want to reveal yet, you see. And also, if we reveal it to the world, I'm certain it will cause great terror and panic. Our scientists here intend to proceed with their experiments on it. Ah, I must ask you to keep what you have learned here a secret. Don't tell anyone at all.
The secret Kulimonian attack continues with still another deadly weapon. High decibel sound waves that destroy vital tissues in skull.
Now when Kokua stood alone in the street, her spirit died. The wind roared in the trees and the shadows tossed in the light of the street lamp.
Teacher, do you hear it? Like a siren, louder and louder. It hurts my head.
Are you ill?
Teacher, I hear it. It's there.
Ah, can you hear that? It's weird.
Huh? It's closer.
As the people become panic-stricken, Starman seeks out the source of the deadly sound. The murderous sound is destroyed, but the Kulimonians continue to spread the deadly germs, which someday soon can kill every living creature on Earth. Starman's battle has just begun. Millions of people are stricken with the disease. Flags are hung outside their doors. Warn those who are still well to keep away. But both old and young are attacked by the dreaded germs.
Anshiro, my son. Anshiro. Anshiro. The disease is here. Children, run home. Get away from here quickly. Anshiro, speak to me.
What happened? She's fainted. No, she's ill. Miss! Miss! Stand back! Give her air! She's ill! Stop the car! Call an ambulance! Hurry!
One fact has become apparent lately. Those affected most seriously by the disease seem to have attended a performance at the Yamano Theater. They are struck almost immediately after seeing the show. You can see here what I mean. We just completed a check of the theater this morning. I'm able to say the disease starts here, but I don't know its bearer.
The Yamano Theater, the apparent source of the dreaded disease, an unusual dance troupe gives a weird performance, attended by Dr. Fukami and his aide, Dr. Shimamura.
Different. I've never seen anyone fly through the air the way they did.
No one can teach that. It has to be inherited. That's obvious. I've suspicions, but I trust that they are wrong. If they are correct, we can all die. You see, I think that the dancers are...
The dancers? Doctor, I beg you to say it.
And I must. A lot of those who contracted the disease came to this theater to watch a show here. Just moments after they left, they became very ill. My theory is, this is a perfect place from which to spread germs. I think you'll agree to that.
I do, Doctor.
That isn't all. My theory goes on. The performers are not of this earth.
And the germs are my space creatures.
Dr. Fukami is correct. Welcome. Welcome, doctors. I have been expecting you.
Look! Run!
As the Kulimonian disease spreads, the authorities decide to evacuate the children from the cities.
Don't worry, children. They'll soon take you back. They'll be able to locate your father, Noriko. I'll let you know just the minute that the doctor is found.
Your father is alive. I will save your father. Soon I will see that he's rescued.
Ah, I'm so glad to hear that. He's very strong, I'd say.
And he's right. Starman is what they call me, little lady. Now, don't cry, not in front of friends.
All right, I'll not cry.
That's a good girl. I'll save your father, that's a promise. Here. You see this ball of crystal? I want you to keep it, understand?
Any reason? Tell us.
The ball will give a signal when your father is safe. And you'll see he'll be found.
I'm glad.
Great.
Thank you, Starman. Send the signal soon.
I'll try. You just keep watching for it. And if you need me, throw the ball on the ground, and no matter what I'm doing, I'll answer the signal. Don't forget to do that, children, huh?
If we throw it when we reach our destination, will you come?
Promise, promise, please.
Now, wait, I have to tell you something about the crystal. Only once are you allowed to use it. Is that clear? Don't forget, I'll be busy seeking Noriko's father. So, signal, just when I'm needed.
Oh, yes, yes.
Noriko,
you have to get
everything. Now, take good care of yourself, children.
Unless the insidious Kulimonian invasion is stopped, these children will never see their homes again.
All right, children, we'll have our picnic here. Those of you who are looking for butterflies, be sure to stay within calling distance. Go on.
We're going to look in the woods. Huh? Let's go. Oh, I see a very pretty one. Ah, there it goes. Come on.
Zero, wait for me. Wait.
I see it.
Noriko! Noriko!
We're over here. Hurry, try to get here.
I can't do it. I can't. Noriko, listen, come back here. You dropped the crystal.
What's the matter?
I thought I'd be killed by that tree, but I don't see it. What happened to it?
What tree do you mean?
A tree? It seemed as large as a whole house. A bolt struck it.
A bolt of lightning? You were seeing things. How can there be lightning without any storm?
I mean it. There was thunder and lightning and rain besides. A lot.
He means it. I think he's kidding.
Look, you can see. See how wet I am. I don't understand. It all seems dry here. There was no storm, you say?
No storm at all today. Let's go on with our hunt.
Here, don't be silly. Oh, the woods are foggy here.
I don't want to go there.
Let's go back.
Through here.
Oh, I can't see the path.
What happened to it? I don't like it here. I'm scared. Let's go on.
Oh.
lead us back.
Then move on.
We should go near it.
Starman, having heard that the deadly germ seemed to have come originally from the Yamano Theater, and like Dr. Fukami, suspecting that the strange dance troupe may be disguised Kulimonians, arrives to investigate. You agreed to give a show for me. It can begin now.
Very well, sir. The troupe will perform a special dance just for you. A preview of tonight's show.
Thank you.
To do it. Look! Over there, Doctor, look!
Father, help me! Don't let me die! Father! Father! I'll die! I'll die!
Noriko! Noriko! I'll save you! Try not to be scared!
Please save me! I can't stand it! If I fall in, I'll die!
Noriko! Dear child! Noriko!
Better speak or you'll see her killed. The rope holding her shall be cut, making her drop into acid, and they too must die.
Noriko!
They're gonna drop me into that lake! Father! Oh, do something!
Noriko! Children!
Then speak. Tell us what we want to know. Speak!
Oh! Oh!
Starman has received the urgent signal and flies to the rescue.
Message, you can see.
Salamander men of Kulimon retreat into their watery element to be ready to fight another day. Headquarters of the Kulimonians, far beneath the sea.
Starman is interfering with our plans.
But even he does not know of our base here. And there is no way that he can discover we are about to begin our final attack.
I propose contacting our spaceships and beginning the attack immediately.
Wait, not yet. Remember, they are developing some weapons to be used against us. And so first, we must locate their secret arsenal and be certain it's destroyed.
I agree. We will have very little opposition once the arsenal is destroyed. And then what?
We take over the Earth! Aye,
aye, aye. At this moment, deep within Earth's secret arsenal...
Gentlemen, our time is running out. The Kulimonians are ready. Soon they will launch their attack. They have an excellent chance to destroy us. Their germ warfare has weakened our army. We are working on immunization. But you know the emergency. The Kulimonians must be stopped, and for that we need a weapon.
It's me, Ikeuchi.
Ikeuchi.
Oh,
what happened? You've been hurt, Ikeuchi.
It happened in the laboratory. Some chemicals flared up, but the burns are not at all serious.
Oh, phone your father. Tell him he'd better come home. Go on.
All right, I will.
Tell him he'd better hurry.
Hello, Noriko. Where is Yuichi?
In his room. Oh, the electricity's off. Isaka, we need a candle so we can see.
It's probably a fuse that's gone. Noriko, is your brother all right?
Yes, the nurse said that it isn't serious. He's all bandaged. And he doesn't want us to visit him long.
Be completely well in a few days. Burns were only second degree.
How do you feel, Ikeuchi?
A little weak, that's about all. I just need some rest. I'll be up and around in a couple of days.
I'm glad to hear it. I was worried.
Now, Father, you better return to the arsenal. I know how important your work is. Important to the whole world. To every human being. Any delay will help the Kulimonians. Return to work.
I'm glad you suggested. I'll go now. Noriko, see that your brother rests. I'm positive he's in good hands.
Here.
Ah, yes.